Oh, Troy, you're such a good teacher.
Yeah, I know. Never not working. Never not working. Never ever not working.
Are you serious?
Never not working. Standard protection that's never not working. Head and Shoulder Scalp Shield technology.
It's never too early to plant the seed, to share the tradition, and instill a sense of pride in your HBCU with your little ones. HBCU Pride and Joy Children's Boutique helps you share your school spirit with a wide selection of adorable kids' apparel and accessories officially licensed from your favorite HBCU. Visit HBCUPrideJoy.com and follow us on all social media at HBCU Pride Joy on Facebook and Twitter.
This is the Dean of the College of HBCU Sports, Kenyatta Cavill of Dr. Cavill's Inside the HBCU Sports Lab with Mike Washington and Charles Bishop. Come mix it up in the lab where the course lecture is in session every Tuesday from 6 o'clock p.m. Central Standard Time on Facebook Live, YouTube Spreaker, or the BCSN app, as we discuss all things about the HBCU sports culture, including exploring the week that was in the sporting HBCU diaspora, as well as the upcoming week of HBCU Sports. With me, the Dean, the College of HBCU Sports, on Dr. Cavill's Inside HBCU Sports Lab with Mike Washington and Charles Bishop. Course lecture dismissed.
Charmin Ultra Soft has so much cushiony softness, it's hard for your family to remember they can use less.
Sweet pillows of softness.
This is soft.
Holy Charmin.
Oh, excuse me.
Roll it back, everybody.
Sorry.
Charmin Ultra Soft is so cushiony soft, you'll want more. But it's so absorbent, you can use less. So it's always worth it. Now, what did we learn about using less?
You gotta roll it back, everybody.
We all go. Why not enjoy the go with Charmin?
From novice to aficionado, find yourself here. High quality cigars plus personal customer service. Slow Burn is Waco's only mobile cigar lounge, featuring a meticulous, curated collection of premium cigars. Visit our website, www.slowburnwaco.com. That's www.slowburnwaco.com.
For 200 years, Montgomery, Alabama has been making history by people who had the courage to stand up for change. Today, this riverfront city has been reborn, embracing the past and looking forward to the future. From the National Memorial for Peace and Justice to the stage of the Alabama Shakespeare Festival, this is where history was and is made. We are proud to call Montgomery home, and together, we can be the change.
Maureen is saving big holiday shopping at Amazon, so now she's free to become Maureen the Merrier. Food is her love language, and she really loves her grandson. Like, really loves.
Nope. Nope.
You want him?
Ooh, I like him.
Quick, the quicker picker-upper. Bounty picks up messes quicker, and each sheet is 2 times more absorbent, so you can use less.
He's an 8.
He's a 9.
Bounty, the quicker picker-upper.
Oh, that spin class was brutal.
Well, you can try using the Buick's massaging seat.
Oh, yeah, that's nice.
Can I use Apple CarPlay to put some music on?
Sure,
it's wireless.
Pick something we all like.
Okay, hold on.
What's your Buick's Wi-Fi password?
Buick Envision 2021.
Oh, you should pick something stronger that's really predictable.
That's a really tight spot.
Don't worry,
I used to hate parallel parking.
Me too.
Hey.
Really outdid yourself.
Yes, we did.
The all-new Buick Envision, an SUV built around you, all of you.
The Cuvée Group is a Florida-based marketing and training consulting firm. We help businesses communicate to their target audience and engage them in conversation. We also help to expand their audiences, which will ultimately result in growth for those organizations. In addition to being a certified constant contact specialist, my colleagues and I are also certified in John Maxwell Leadership Principles. We use these proven principles to conduct workshops, training, and private coaching sessions for individuals and companies looking to take things to the next level. Contact us to schedule a free consultation. Issues today, Don't delay. Call Cuvée.
Since 2002, Empowerment Resources, Inc., a nonprofit organization, has empowered more than 1,500 youth and adults in Duval and surrounding counties. Through its programs, Journey into Womanhood, Girls Mentoring, Life Skills for Teens, and Parenting Education Coaching. To get involved with programs, volunteer, or donate, visit www.empowermentresourcesinc.org. Follow us on social media, facebook.com/empowerment.resources and instagram.com/empowermentJAX.
Supermarket sushi, really?
No. Wait, Troy, you work here?
I'm never not working. Like Head & Shoulder Scalp Shield technology, up to 100% dandruff protection, even between washes.
Never not working, huh?
Oh, Troy, you're such a good teacher.
Yeah, I know. Never not working. Never not working. Never ever not working.
Are you serious?
Never not working. Dandruff protection that's never not working. Head & Shoulder Scalp Shield technology.
It's never...
Good evening and welcome to the Mitchell Center on the campus of South Alabama University. We are here for the nightcap, the second game of the Bridge Builder Classic, inaugural year, alongside the CAU Panther himself, Mr. TJ Wills. I am Roy Evans. We are the Black College Sports Network live on HBCU League Pass, and we are getting prepared for, the tip-off. Okay, so they just reset the clock or the score. Okay. I was about to say that is not the score of the game, but this actually is. Tonight's nightcap features the Wildcats of Bethune-Cookman University traveling all the way from Daytona Beach, Florida, facing the Hornets of Alabama State University, a short 2.5-hour ride up I-65. TJ, what's going to happen in this game? Pleasure to be by your side, Roy, but what I think we're going to get tonight is a grudge match between two struggling teams that haven't really found the right track on their season yet. Bama State's coming in at 4-15 overall. Bethune-Cookman coming in at 5-14. Both have the same conference record at 3-4, so really I'm just looking to see who's going to get the say-so in this conference match.
Well, as you're saying it, they get those things. We will see who gets the 500 and who drops two games behind. Looks like we're getting our starting lineups. We are being told that there's some issue with the arena's internet going on, so it's making it a little difficult. Hopefully we will get the live stats for this game, as we were not able to get them before.
The last game was a struggle for just to get the rosters.
Yeah. So we're gonna work that out. And let's see here. I believe I have the walk. Let's see, which roster did you send me? Or did you send me both of them? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Well, let's do this. Let you take Alabama State. We'll take Bethune-Cookman.
All right, sounds good to me.
And we'll follow that. So I'm going to see who this is as we're starters. So our starters for Bethune-Cookman, we have number 5. And, of course, their numbers are not in order. Number 5, Damian McIntyre. Number 3, who was on their roster, Marcus Garrett. We're waiting to see some of the other players. And, of course, Bethune-Cookman is coached by NBA former All-Star Mr. Reggie Theus. He is now the head coach and athletic director at Bethune-Cookman getting in. And so we've got two former NBA players on the sideline as Mo Williams' team, the Alabama State Hornets, get ready to do battle in both of their first seasons.
And this is practically a home game for Alabama State.
It
got
is.
The band here. Yeah. The crowd is live and loud with all the high school games before and the other game that took place just before this one.
Yeah.
So let's go ahead and get to the starting lineups for Alabama State. Looks like we got starting at forward, Jordan O'Neal, 6'7", sophomore.
Right behind him, we got E.J. Clark, 5'11 guard, who is a junior this season. Also in the backcourt, we got Kenny Strawbridge, 6'6 guard, also a sophomore. Another guard to go in the backcourt, Isaiah Rains, 6'3 sophomore.
And TJ, as you said, this is practically a home game for Alabama State, and the band came in. For those that did not see the beginning of the stream, we did have them doing their march-in, and they had a little drumline presentation. Mm-hmm. For those that did miss it, we will run that again for you during halftime of this game to give you all an opportunity to see the Marching Hornets. I believe it's called the Marching Hornets. So you guys will get a chance to see them. To finish out the rosters for Bethune-Cookman, number 12, Kevin Davis. Also,
looks like number 5 also.
Yep, already called out number 5 there.
Number 12.
Uh-huh. And let's see, number 22. Number 22 is Mr. Dylan Robertson. And there should be one more. Let's see, 22. And that's number 30 for Bethune-Cookman. And number 30 is Joe French.
And we are underway.
Yeah.
Looks like E.J. Clark trying to get the offense settled in real quick. It's going to cut through to the sideline. And that is Trace Young with the ball, folks. The leading scorer for this Alabama State team as he puts in the mid-range bucket to get them on the board first.
All right. Alabama State strikes first.
Looks like they have a little half-court trap.
Yeah.
Some pressure. Able to squeeze the pass through.
And that was a good shot. It didn't fall for him, but he was wide open. Had gotten the defense
and Trace Young to the cup. What the score. 4 quick points for the scoring guard.
Very fluid as the young man went down there. That was a nice look.
Very calm, very poised. Just to start off this game, looks like they're in a 1-2-2 now, switching up the zone. Getting out there to the shooter, cutting through the middle.
Oh, nice cut to the basket.
And one.
Very nice cut to the basket. I like to see guards aggressive like that. When you're swinging it out, people are expecting your perimeter shooters to get in there. The shooter found that guy cutting to the basket, and this is why your coaches always tell young people, keep moving.
And, you know, that's the first foul of the game. Kind of came quick for Alabama State. And last game, they had 20 fouls in total. 20. Mm.
Was not able to convert the and one. Our score, ASU 4, Bethune-Cookman 2.
The E.J. Clark drives to the cup, kicks it out. Trace Young on top.
About to say, was the young man going to show us the range also? Showed us, errant pass there, taken away by Bethune. Oh.
Drives to the cup, easy
nice
layup.
Nice way to follow the basket there. That was number 12, Mr. Kevin Davis. Okay, someone said a different name than what I have on my roster here. But, yeah, that was good
EJ
heads up
Clark
play.
To the cup. Oh, Trace Young almost with the putback dunk.
He's showing us that
with
he can play at the rim.
And he draws the foul. Yeah, he's definitely not afraid to take it inside at all, Roy.
Yeah, he's good in the paint there. That's a good sign for you.
Let's see, Trace Young. Oh, did they call that on the ground? Yep.
Yes, they did.
On the ground. Let's see what kind of play they got for him. Corner three. Good closeout. Swings it back up top. About 13 seconds on the shot clock. A.J. Clark takes it in. Stops.
Oh. Blocked from behind. It is, yeah.
And
this ball is going to be out on Alabama State. It will be Cookman's ball.
Let's see if Alabama reverts back to that 2-3 or they stick in that 1-2-2. Basically begging the Wildcats to shoot that three ball.
Yeah, they really are. But the irony of what I'm seeing, though, is that the Wildcats are making a concerted effort to move towards the paint. They are not standing out there behind that three-point line. So I'm not sure if that's something that maybe that State saw in the scouting report that they wanted to try to use. But it definitely looks like something that Bethune is not trying to do right now.
Yep. Looks like Alabama State using a little give-and-go offense. Kicks to the corner, in and out three, doesn't get it to go. Looks like Bethune's trying to get the ball up quickly. As the ball is tipped away, going to stay on this side of the court. As they'll take the ball side out. Looks like, Bethune might be a little stuck in the corner.
There you go. Somebody's got to be open if there are two people on you.
Kicks it out.
And this is, so we're seeing something early with Bethune. They are having trouble with picking up their dribble. You know, and instead of continuing to dribble, they're getting these traps, and they're doing the one thing a coach will tell you not to do is pick up your dribble.
Yep. As a bad pass, Bama State able to stick with it. Number one, all the way to the cup, and he gets fouled on the way up. That's DJ Jackson, the sixth man on the season for this Alabama State squad, as he's headed to the free throw line.
His first personal foul, second team foul. At the line for Alabama State, number one, DJ Jackson, shooting two.
Let's see if he's able to put in this first one. As last game, they shot a poor 56% from the free throw line. And their woes continue as he misses the first one. Able to put the second one through. As they go back, now they're in a 1-3-1, appears. Good closeouts. Ball to the middle, and he's able to put it in. As Mr. Jackson brings the ball up the court. Finds the ball down low. Puts it up for the easy lay. Looks like Bethune's trying to figure out this 1-3-1 zone that Alabama State is putting on him. Pulls up from three, puts it in from deep. That is number 30. Joe French from deep. Ball is in DJ Jackson's hand as he's able to get it stripped away.
Ripped. That's going to be backcourt. They did have possession of the ball at that time. All right, so we've got our first official timeout here. So what we're going to do is we're going to take a break, and we will return. You're watching the Bridge Builder Classic right here on HBCU League Pass with the Black College Sports Network.
For 200 years, Montgomery, Alabama has been making history by people who had the courage to stand up for change. Today, this riverfront city has been reborn, embracing the past and looking forward to the future. From the National Memorial for Peace and Justice to the stage of the Alabama Shakespeare Festival, this is where history was and is made. We are proud to call Montgomery home, and together, we can be the change.
Nope. Nope.
Come on, him?
Ooh, I like him.
Quick, the quicker picker-upper. Bounty picks up messes quicker, and each sheet is 2 times more absorbent, so you can use less.
He's an 8.
He's a 9.
Bounty, the quicker picker-upper.
Charmin Ultra Soft has so much cushiony softness, it's hard for your family to remember they can use less.
Sweet pillows of softness.
This is soft.
Holy Charmin.
Oh, excuse me. Roll it back, everybody.
Sorry.
Charmin Ultra Soft is so cushiony soft, you'll want more. But it's so absorbent, you can use less. So it's always worth it. Now, what did we learn about using less?
You gotta roll it back, everybody.
We all go. Why not enjoy the go with Charmin?
And welcome back to the Mitchell Center here at South Alabama University. Our score, ASU 7, Bethune-Cookman 11, as we are in the second game of the inaugural Bridge Builder Classic.
And that's Christian McCray from the mid-range jumper. Gets the quick, easy two out of the timeout. Looks like Alabama State is in a 1-3-1 slash half-court trap, and it's working. The six-man DJ Jackson works the offense. Ball back to McCray. He pulls up for mid-range again. Doesn't get it to go in. Rebound for Bethune. Ooh.
Not sure what was going on there.
Court's looking a little slippery maybe. And that's another turnover.
See, they get it moving there. Oh, finds the open shooter. He had a wide open shot. He must not really be a fan of his three-point shot because he was.
He passed that up for that mid-range.
Wide open.
I think that's his game, though, because that's 3 consecutive shots from the mid-range that he took from around that 15 to 18-foot mark. So I feel like that's his comfort zone rather than, you know, that three ball, you know, plus 20 feet. But definitely was wide open. Now Bethune on offense. Looks like Alabama State got some subs in. Juan Reyna in at the guard position. As Bethune takes it inside, kicks it back out. 8 seconds on the shot, puts it up, and it's in with the floater. Number 30 with a nice touch for Bethune. That is Joe French. And EJ Clark is back in for DJ Jackson. As they work the ball around the top of the perimeter. They kick it out. EJ Clark for three. And it rattles in for three. Now Bethune trying to work the offense around. Number 30, Joe French from deep, and he puts it in again as he shows the crowd that he's got the stroke from deep. EJ Clark brings the ball back up the court. Let's see if they can respond with a three of their own. Works the ball around the perimeter once again. Juan Reyna with the ball. Dishes it down low to Jacoby Long. He kicks it to the corner for an air ball. That hit absolutely nothing.
Official timeout on the floor.
And we have an official timeout. We will be right back to the Bridge Builder Classic here with the Black College Sports Network.
From novice to aficionado, find yourself here. High quality cigars plus personal customer service. Slow Burn is Waco's only mobile cigar lounge, featuring a meticulous, curated collection of premium cigars. Visit our website, www.slowburnwaco.com. That's www.slowburnwaco.com.
It's never too early to plant the seed, to share the tradition, and instill a sense of pride in your HBCU with your little ones. HBCU Pride and Joy Children's Boutique helps you share your school spirit with a wide selection of adorable kids' apparel and accessories officially licensed from your favorite HBCU. Visit HBCUPrideJoy.com and follow us on all social media at HBCU Pride Joy on Facebook and Twitter.
Turn to action here again. The Marching Hornet band getting it going during the timeouts there, bringing you the true HBCU culture and experience of HBCU basketball. So Bethune brings the ball up court again, leading by four, 16-12. 11:35 left in this first half.
And really their main source of offense has been number 30, Joe French, who's really been getting it going early on in this game. As he's smothered by Juan Reyna. About 5 seconds left on the clock. They got to put a shot up.
Somebody's got to get it up. They're not going to get it off. But that's going to get bailed out. He is going to get bailed out there. They call that on number Mr. Lynch, Isaiah Lynch, number 24. That was a horrible foul just then. They were under 1 second, and there was no way that that shot was going to get up or hit the rim before the clock expired.
And you could clearly see the frustration on Mo Williams' face over there on the sideline.
Yeah.
He's irate about that foul. But let's see if they can cash in. And they do. That's
extending their lead to five.
Who is that at the line? Is that?
That is number three.
Marcus Garrett.
Yep.
See if Mr. Garrett could put the second one in. And it rattles on in. And he's going to be replaced by number two, Jacoby Long. To get a little bit of a defensive presence out on the court. Let's see what E.J. Clark can do for the Alabama State offense. Looks like they're sticking with the simple pass and cut offense right now. Reynigan smothered on the other side of the court. And that was Kenny Strawbridge on the miss, but Reyna with a hustle, and he loses the ball. And that's going to be a kick ball going the other way to Bethune.
You know, right now, early in this game, it seems like both teams are having spurts where they just seem to be somewhat out of control, moving around a little bit too fast, not really thinking and reacting and just kind of doing things.
A little bit out of sorts. And I think that's going to be because of the defensive presence and the defensive pressure that they're applying on each side of the court. As Reyna dishes it down low.
We're going to call that on the floor.
A little mismatch down there. You got small guy E.J. Clark on number 12 from Bethune. That's Kevin Davis, who's 6'5".
Yeah, slight mismatch in height on that one.
Joe French with the floater, and he has been nothing but money to start off this game.
Extending the Cookman lead to eight.
As E.J. Clark brings the ball up the court. Back to the offense, pass and cut. Trying to find a mismatch, an open lane. Kenny Strawbridge. Fadeaway jumper is in.
And Hornets, after about a 3 to 4 minute stretch, get back on the board with their first 2 points. Yeah, it looks like we're giving it a shot, but it doesn't look like we're going to get the stats that we're looking for.
It looks like Bama State is back to a 2-3, but extended. Nope, now they're back in man. Trying to force a turnover. 5 seconds on the clock. And they force him into a bad shot. Great defensive possession right there, but they were able to stick with the ball. So Bethune is going to get the ball inside out. See if they get a quick score. As they kick the ball out. Let's see, they're just holding the ball out, working it. Joe French down the lane. And that's going to be a charge all day.
Yep, he stood in. Good way. Number two stood in there, got his feet settled, and took the charge. He was literally standing right outside of the arc and knew exactly what he was doing. It's called, that's a headsy play.
Yep. Getting the ball down low. Now to number two. That is Jordan O'Neal with the bucket.
And just like that, the score has been cut to four. You know, the lead has been cut to four.
Jacoby Long running the point guard position right now. As he kicks it down low and he dribbles it off his own foot.
Yep.
That's Dylan Robertson with the turnover. Ball going the other way to Alabama State as they try to cut into this four-point deficit. And this small ball lineup by Alabama State has been working so far.
It has, which is kind of interesting, noticing the decided height advantage, like you said, with the small ball that they're playing. But
as E.J. Clark turns the ball over, oh, he blows the layup, but luckily number 12 right there for Bethune is there to clean up the mess. Kevin Davis with the putback.
And again, another, that's fundamental basketball. When you see that type of thing happen, don't just stand there. Run back with the man who's dribbling down court.
Hustle every foot of this court. It's going to pay off. As Robertson picks up the ticky-tack foul right there. Didn't really need it. So Alabama State's going to get the ball on the side. As E.J. Clark checks out the game, and Isaiah Range is back in the ball game, as well as Trace Young. And Range takes it to the rim, but he isn't able to convert it. Bethune the other way, they have numbers. Number one with the pull-up jumper, doesn't sink it. And that's going to be out on Bethune. So Alabama State going the other way.
And with that, we have an official timeout on the floor. We're going to step away. We'll be right back with more right here with the Black College Sports Network on HBCU League Pass.
Oh, that spin class was brutal.
Well, you can try using the Buick's massaging seat.
Oh, yeah, that's nice.
Can I use Apple CarPlay to put some music on?
Sure.
It's wireless.
Pick something we all like.
Okay, hold on.
What's your Buick's Wi-Fi password?
Buick Envision 2021.
Oh, you should pick something stronger. That's really predictable.
That's a really tight spot.
Don't worry.
I used to hate parallel parking.
Me too.
Hey.
Really outdid yourself.
Yes, we did.
The all-new Buick Envision. An SUV built around you. All of you.
Alabama has been making history by people who had the courage to stand up for change. Today, this riverfront city has been reborn, embracing the past and looking forward to the future. From the National Memorial for Peace and Justice to the stage of the Alabama Shakespeare Festival, this is where history was and is made. We are proud to call Montgomery home, and together, we can be the change.
Nope. Nope.
Come on, him?
Ooh, I like him.
The Quicker Picker Upper. Bounty picks up messes quicker, and each sheet is 2 times more absorbent, so you can use less.
He's an 8.
He's a 9.
Bounty, the Quicker Picker Upper.
It's like a loop machine.
Charmin Ultra Soft has so much cushiony softness, it's hard for your family to remember they can use less.
Sweet pillows of softness.
This is soft.
Holy Charmin.
Oh, excuse me. Roll it back, everybody. Everybody.
Sorry.
Charmin Ultra Soft is so cushiony soft, you'll want more. But it's so absorbent, you can use less. So it's always worth it.
Now, what did we learn about using less?
You gotta roll. Everybody,
we all go. Why not enjoy the go with Charmin?
We are back to live action here at the Mitchell Center on the campus of South Alabama University. Bethune-Cookman leads by 6 over the Hornets of Alabama State.
Looks like Kenny Strawbridge taking the shot from mid-range. Isn't able to get it to go in.
Looks like he was able to throw the ball off of one of the Wildcats.
So they're going to retain possession. Looking for Isaiah Range coming off the screen. Juan Reyna in the corner. Step back three. Long miss. And is it going to stay on that side of the court? It looks like it is. So the Hornets will get another possession.
Coach Theus is not happy about that call.
Having to play defense 3 times in a row is quite annoying. Let's see. That's Jordan O'Neal with an offensive rebound, and he gets the second chance to go in.
And our lead is now back down to 4. ASU hadn't been really able to break that four-point barrier in the last 5 minutes or so.
Yep. See if they can strand a couple defensive stops, as that's number 3, Marcus Garrett.
It won't start there.
Let's see what Isaiah Range can do on the offensive side of the court. Motion the offense to cut. And that's going to be an off the ball foul. So the Hornets are going to take the ball from out of bounds. See if they can drop a play real quick to get a quick bucket here. Trace Young comes off the screen hard, and he loses the ball in the middle.
Well, just got notification. We will have an opportunity to talk to the Alabama State Athletic Director, Dr. Jason Cable, is going to make his way up here at some point during the game. Let Hornet Nation know what's happening up there in Montgomery, Alabama.
And it looks like the ball's going to be going the other way, Roy. Offensive foul. Look like an illegal screen, so Bethune's going to take over. And that's Marcus Garrett all the way to the rim, and he misses it off the high of the backboard.
Rebounded.
Nice hustle play.
Don't see too many air balls when you're that close to the rim.
Looks like DJ Jackson's back in the game. Kicks it to Isaiah Range. Finds Trace Young. He pulls it from 3, and it's a little bit short.
Right. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
The hustle play from Jacoby Long is able to get them another possession on offense. So Bethune is really not getting no defensive rebounds, and they're having to play defense longer than what they should have to.
6 minutes left in this first half. Our score, 18-24. Bethune-Cookman leads. State off the
inbound screen.
That's Christian McCray with another mid-range jumper.
And again, let's see. Will Bethune be able to keep the four-point lead, or will ASU finally get one of those defensive stops and a chance to cut it to two? Oh, nice move!
Oh, and he's met at the rim.
He's met at the rim, but that is going to be considered a mugging, and he'll be at the line.
Of course, the Hornets think that was all ball.
Of course they do. And that was, there was a whole lot of body involved in that. That's Mr. Collins Joseph.
Yep.
Trying to get these, like I said, they've got the rosters by names and not numbers, so we're trying to make sure of that. But that was an extremely aggressive move, and I like to see guards do that. He did not hesitate. When he saw an opening, he attacked it. That is what caused the defense to have to collapse on him and put the body on him.
Yep. Well, have you seen this guy jump in warm-ups?
No, I did not see him jump during the warm-ups.
They was lobbing it up to him. He was hitting windmills. He has to be close to a 40-inch very easy.
Okay.
So he was definitely trying to put someone on his mixtape for the season.
And that is from the six-foot senior guard. Definitely an aggressive defender. Looks like, what is this? Bethune is in a man-to-man defense.
Yep. As they have been all game. Hornets really been sticking to the zone, forcing them to hit that outside shot.
So Mr. Joseph is going to get that foul called against him.
Puts DJ at the line. Sinks the first one. 1-on-1 opportunity.
Let's see. We might finally get an opportunity to break that four-point barrier.
Can he bring it to within three? No, he can't.
I really hope that this 4 points is not the bugaboo for Alabama State during this game.
Lob. Boom! That's Dylan Robertson with the flush. Doesn't have to get up that high when he's 6'9".
Right, yeah. Stretch your arms out a little bit and go get it.
McCray with another mid-range jumper. He sure does love that mid-range jumper right there. That's number four for him.
Well, hey, look, if that's what makes it work for you, you go ahead and you stick with it.
Looks like Garrett Jackson trying to get some breathing room. Finds Mr. French in the corner. Struggling to get into their offensive set kind of quick. They're looking a little stagnant. Ooh, with the cross and off the top of the backboard.
And no foul in that. Bethune rebounds the ball.
Oh, he has to shoot it. Oh, but Isaiah Range with a steal. DJ Jackson to Trace.
And that is a nice fast break way to execute your offense. And they have finally broken that 2 point barrier, the 4 point barrier. Now at 2 points, 4 minutes, right about 4:06 left here in the game. Just want to give you guys some information. So for those who are watching, we know we've got a couple of comments about the lights. The lighting in this building is somewhat awkward when you have to be shifted sideways with our camera set up, and that's what they have here for. So we are not able, we apologize that when it does swing down to what we'll call the right side of the court, it does give it a different look. But what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and let the Marching Hornets entertain you a little bit during this break. as we return back to live action. As we are getting things together, the Hornets are back out on the court awaiting the Wildcats' return. All right, 4 minutes, 6 seconds left here in the first half. You are Coach Williams. What do you tell your team on the sideline?
Well, first, I'm glad that we got over that four-point hump that we couldn't get past. So now we're down, only down two. We're in good shape right now. We'd like to create a little bit more turnovers, a little bit more, you know, defensive pressure, but I'm sure that's going to come along with, you know, the defensive strategy that they have. And really just executing on offense, running their sets, getting the ball to the open man, and finally just knocking down shots.
Ooh.
And there goes a turnover.
Yeah. Yeah, he threw that in trying to get to the big man, but again, I think some of these guards, that needs to be something, and I'm surprised that he would have made that pass. It's very difficult, and I think what guards need to understand, it is very difficult for you to bounce pass down inside of the paint to your big man, because that's the longest distance for him to get to, and of course, everybody else is right there around him.
As they did it again.
Yeah.
And a shot clock violation, you know. And those are the turnovers that Coach Williams is looking for. You know,
right.
They want to get down, first turnovers, get those fast break points. Those are easy points for you to get on the board. Yeah. Not having to run an offensive set every time is crucial to winning a game.
And I think that's one of the things that they need to look at doing a little bit more of.
Trace Young takes it in.
Yeah, the few times that they have gotten out on the break, on the fast break opportunities, they've been beneficial to them.
Yep.
And we've now got a tie score, 27 all, 3 minutes, 10 seconds left here in the first half.
Go straight up, and, yeah, number 10 is displeased with that call. As they usually are.
Well, you know, that is the normal and natural reaction for everyone who gets called for a foul, no matter what level you're playing on.
And Marcus Garrett back to the free throw line, as he's been a regular this game.
Yeah. See, we're hoping that at some point we might be able to get the live stats, but it does not seem to be happening for us, folks. So we apologize for that there.
Luck has not been on our side today.
Apparently they are using the internal internet here in the building that they are not able to get connection to stay solid on. And, of course, we are on our own broadcast internet inside of the facility.
DJ Jackson with the ball on the wing. See if Trace Young can get going. Kind of quiet.
Well, I was waiting for him to try a three-pointer. There he is. Misses on that first one. It was a good look.
Yep. Just got to get a little bit more legs up under him. But a relatively low scoring half.
Yeah.
A couple of missed shots, you know. Turnovers. Let's see. Can Garrett get it to go in? And he does.
He does. Taking the lead right back up to 4 points for the Wildcats.
That has been the magic number today.
Yeah. Let's see what ASU is able to do.
Young on the ground. Number three's got to be careful there.
Yeah,
with the ref.
Right. You know, and I'm glad the ref just kind of picked up the ball and kept moving, because the young man, needless to say, was frustrated with himself. He thought he was able to get in there to get that.
Yep.
But was not, so.
And I believe that is Michael Barber at the free throw. First time there today, so let's see if he could put these two baskets in. Sinks the first. As Bama has improved their free throw shooting significantly from last game, as they shot at about 56%. And I'm still in school, so I'm pretty sure that's failing, Roy.
yes, that would classify as such. So our lead is still three. Just at 2 minutes left here in the first half. Bethune-Cookman trying to extend their three-point lead. And with a three, it was blocked by Mr. Young. Oh, but he gets it back. Follows his own shot. Was able to get that.
And French has been efficient all night. Even with that black shot right there, able to still stay with it, find the ball, and put the ball in for an easy layup. As DJ Jackson brings the ball up the court.
Another one of those fundamentals of basketball, follow your shot.
And I'm telling you, McCray has got the softest touch in the world tonight. That's about five made mid-ranges from that spot.
Bethune up by three. Minute 15 left here in the first half. The ASU band screaming out defense.
French.
And there is nothing that you can do about defending that three.
With the smooth stroke. They better get a hand on him, hand in his face, something.
Yeah, he did not hesitate with that. He went right up and was like, yeah, this one is getting shot.
Let's see, range with a little bit of range. Not quite. French corrals the rebound. Let's see what they can do. About 35 seconds left on the clock. That's Jacoby Long with the ball. Gives it to French, which isn't a bad idea on offense. As he takes it all the way to the cup with the up and under. And he talks stuff to the guy on the ground.
Extending the Bethune-Cookman lead to eight. Coach Mo Williams, we're going to stay here. I think it's only going to be a 30-second timeout. I've got 11 seconds left here in the half.
This is a 30-second timeout.
As thought. So what do you think Coach Williams decided to make this call to timeout right before the half?
I think he's tired of number 30 scoring on him. Honestly, that's been Bethune's number one option and their only option right now. He's been their bread and butter tonight. Putting in bucket after bucket and just keep feeding the hot hand. But if I'm Coach Mo Williams, I'm getting a guy on him. Even if you're in the zone, maybe applying a box and one, just have a guy stick with him no matter where he's at on the court. Follow him, get a hand on his hip, hand in his face, whatever you got to do so that way he doesn't score the ball on you anymore.
All right, well, let's see what they come up with out of this timeout. I believe it is ASU ball. So we're going to see. Let's see if they're able to get a score here in this last 11 seconds. And that is not what Coach Williams wanted.
Can French put it in? No. Oh.
Was not able to get that to fall. So at the half, our score, Alabama State 30, Bethune-Cookman 38. As promised, we're going to give you the Alabama State band's performance prior to the game, because there will be some activities, of course, taking place on the field. We'll be back with more right after this.
Maureen is saving big holiday shopping at Amazon, so now she's free to become Maureen the Merrier. Food is her love language, and she really loves her grandson, like really loves.
Troy, you work here?
I'm never not working. Like Head & Shoulder Scalp Shield technology, up to 100% dandruff protection, even between washes.
Never not working.
Never not working. Never ever not working. Head & Shoulder Scalp Shield, never not working.
Maureen is saving big holiday shopping at Amazon, so now she's free to become Maureen the Merrier. Food is her love language, and she really loves her grandson, like really loves.
Troy, you work here?
I'm never not working. Like Head & Shoulder Scalp Shield technology, up to 100% dandruff protection, even between washes.
Never not working.
Never not working. Never ever not working. Head & Shoulder Scalp Shield, never not working.
And welcome back to the Mitchell Center here on the campus of South Alabama University. We're at the half. The Bethune-Cookman Wildcats lead the Hornets of Alabama State by the score of 38-30. TJ, what did you see that happened in this first half, and what do you think the halftime adjustments need to be for this game?
What I seen was Bethune-Cookman have a player like number 30, Mr. French, just basically killing the Alabama State defense the whole game. He's taking it inside. He's hitting mid-range. He's hitting it from deep. So, really, the adjustments I'm looking forward to see is the ones that Coach Williams makes from Alabama State and how he's going to affect Mr. French as not being as efficient on offense.
Okay. So, what about on the offensive side of the ball? What do you think the Hornets need to do to get back into this?
On the offense is fine. I think they've been fine. They just got to hit shots, honestly. They just got to keep moving without the ball, especially keep cutting to the rim, and they will find easy baskets that way. It's just a matter of knocking them down.
All right. Well, we are just about ready for the start of the tip-off. Again, this is the second game of the Bridge Builder Classic weekend, brought to you by HBCU League Pass right here on the Black College Sports Network. And we are live from the University of South Alabama in Mobile, Alabama. Again, we'll be back in the fall for the Gulf Coast Challenge again. Second year of that event. Second year we'll be involved with it.
Yep.
So we're looking forward to that and getting back into it. So we will get the game started. And we know that we're going to have AD Cable, Dr. Jason Cable from Alabama State, is going to be joining us soon and get a chance to talk to him about what's going on with Hornet Nation. Nice up and under move, was not able to get it. And now this is one thing I will say, TJ. I think one of the other things that Alabama State's going to need to do is be much better with offensive rebounds in this half. They're going to have to get some second shots. Bethune-Cookman was able to get a good number of second shots, although they were pretty efficient on offense. When they did have the chance to get those offensive rebounds, they were getting them and getting the chance to put them back into the bucket. So
Yeah, and all that is just hustle plays, honestly. Right. Doing the extra little things is what's going to go a long way into this ball game.
Well, that's it. You know, and it's going to be an interesting season to see how these two teams play. I am actually, you know, if they make it into the top eight, I'm going to be definitely interested in seeing how they play in the tournament.
Yep.
Because you've got two first-year coaches, and, of course, they're trying to figure it out, get their team, you know, see what they've got from a team. And another dunk.
The nice alley-oop.
Yep.
Lob to Dylan Robertson again for another big-time flush. But, yeah, I get what you're saying. Two big-time head coaches, you know, with sadly their teams are kind of struggle a little bit this season. But if they're able to get into that tournament, they both have – you know, big players like Trace Young and Joe French on their respective squads that can, you know, lead them to an upset or,
That's right.
A long run in the tournament.
Most definitely. And that's what you have to be prepared for. As the lead is now 10, 32, 42, Bethune-Cookman. And that's going to be called
hand check, I believe.
20, Mr. Sprawlbridge on Alabama State. So, of course, it's going to be a non-shooting foul. Let's see if they're able to get it in.
Avoids the foul right there. Goes for another lob, but unable to connect.
Yeah,
Mr. Clark from the corner three.
And he gets it.
And that was another key, just hitting shots. That's going to be big for this team.
That was one of the things you said, is they got us an official timeout here. So we'll go ahead and take us a break, and we'll be back right here on HBCU League Pass.
From novice to aficionado, find yourself here. High-quality cigars plus personal customer service. Slow Burn is Waco's only mobile cigar lounge, featuring a meticulous, curated collection of premium cigars. Visit our website, www.slowburnwaco.com. That's www.slowburnwaco.com.
It's never too early to plant the seed, to share the tradition, and instill a sense of pride in your HBCU with your little ones. HBCU Pride and Joy Children's Boutique helps you share your school spirit with a wide selection of adorable kids' apparel and accessories officially licensed from your favorite HBCU. Visit HBCUPrideJoy.com and follow us on all social media at HBCU Pride Joy on Facebook and Twitter.
That spin class was brutal.
Well, you can try using the Buick's massaging seat.
Ooh, yeah, that's nice.
Can I use Apple CarPlay to put some music on?
Sure.
It's wireless.
It's something we all like.
Okay, hold on.
What's your Buick's Wi-Fi password?
Buick Envision 2021.
Oh, you should pick something stronger that's really predictable.
That's a really tight spot.
Don't worry.
I used to hate parallel parking.
Me too.
Hey.
Really outdid yourself.
Yes, we did.
The all-new Buick Envision. An SUV built around you. All of
it. And welcome back. Our score, Bethune-Cookman 42, Alabama State 35. As we get into this, 17:50 left here in the second half. Alabama State picking up man-to-man defense, full court pressure. Seeing if they can disrupt this offense of Bethune-Cookman. Oh,
bad pass right there by Trace Young. And that's Marcus Garrett able to draw the foul right there.
Yeah.
And that's one thing you don't want if you're Alabama State. You don't want the guy to get the defensive rebound on one end, take it all the way up the court, and draw a foul. That's you're not getting back on defense.
Yeah.
And that's just hustle. You know, you got to have hustle on defense.
Definitely.
But he misses the first free throw, so. See if he's able to put the second one in. Mr. Garrett, been to the free throw line a few times tonight.
Able to convert. 43-35. Wildcats still leading.
Let's see if Kenny Strawbridge can get anything going. Kicks it back to Mr. Clark. Looks like they're trying to find Young off the screen. Strawbridge all the way to the line.
Oh!
He slams it.
And that'll get your teammates and your fans riled up. Mr. Strawbridge going strong to the basket.
Good defense there by Mr. Young. See if that dunk gives them a little bit of a spark. Hands up. That's 5 seconds. That's great defense right there by Alabama State. That's exactly what you want. Force them into turnovers, into tough offensive possessions. And that was Mr. French who had the ball.
Well, let's get something corrected here. I wanna get a point across. Apparently, someone said Jacoby Long, and I was told that the young man's name is Jordan O'Neill. So we will correct that. I guess this is Dicasso who's correcting us. So we apologize with what we're getting here. So like I said, some of the issues, there are no live stats, and the rosters are
mixed up.
they're somewhat challenging, but we accept that. We apologize again to Mr. Jordan O'Neill. So we hope we got that correct, and we will look forward to making sure that we keep that correct moving forward. 37-43. Bethune-Cookman leads. Alabama State on offense with the ball in with a nice one.
Trace Young right there.
Yeah. And now I'm expecting to see him get more aggressive in this half.
Yep.
I thought he was a little lackadaisical, didn't really go after his shot as much as I thought he was. But I think they're going to need – Alabama State's going to need him to get aggressive, to go at the basket and try to make some things happen. And just like you said, though,
they won't be able to get anything going until they stop him. You got to put a lid on him from long range.
Mr. French is doing exactly what he wants to at this point.
And then some.
Yeah. Interior pass. Oh, right, nice hesitation.
And that's Mr. Jordan O'Neill right there.
Getting up in there. Thought that was going to be a mistake for him, but he was able to get the defender in the air. Didn't get the foul. I know a couple of folks wanted to see that. But that was a good, strong move on the inside, making sure that he established his position. We'll be back with more right here on the Black College Sports Network.
For 200 years, Montgomery, Alabama has been making history by people who had the courage to stand up for change. Today, this riverfront city has been reborn, embracing the past and looking forward to the future. From the National Memorial for Peace and Justice to the stage of the Alabama Shakespeare Festival, this is where history was and is made. We are proud to call Montgomery home, and together, we can be the change.
Nope. Nope.
Come on, him?
Ooh, I like him.
Quick, the quicker picker-upper. Bounty picks up messes quicker, and each sheet is 2 times more absorbent, so you can use less.
He's an 8.
He's a 9.
Bounty, the quicker picker-upper.
Oh,
Charmin Ultra Soft has so much cushiony softness, it's hard for your family to remember they can use less.
Sweet pillows of softness.
This is soft.
Holy Charmin.
Oh, excuse me. Roll it back, everybody.
Sorry.
Charmin Ultra Soft is so cushiony soft, you'll want more. But it's so absorbent, you can use less. So it's always worth it.
Now, what did we learn about using less?
You gotta roll it back, everybody.
We all go. Why not enjoy the go with Charmin?
From novice.
Hello, and welcome back to the Mitchell Center here on the campus of South Alabama University. As Marty, the mascot, I guess from Mardi Gras, do you know, Mr. Willis, that actually Mobile, Alabama is the original home of the Mardi Gras?
I could go home and say that I learned something new today, because I did not know that.
Yes, sir, it is. Mobile, Alabama is the home of the original Mardi Gras, and it then somehow made its way to New Orleans.
I thought it would have originated in New Orleans, but I guess not.
No, yeah, it started here. And apparently a lot of people still do come here for their Mardi Gras.
That's interesting. I never heard of that. As
Bethune throws the ball away on that one. Alabama State has gotten to the game within five, and we're going to see what they're able to do here now. See if Coach Mo Williams put the plan in place for his team to execute.
Looks like O'Neal kicks it down low to Young. Not able to get it to go. And we're going the other way.
Going the other way, yep.
Thought Bethune might have touched that one last, but I guess not. Ref's got a better view than I do, so.
Well, actually, the one that made the call was nowhere near the ball. But I'm not going to get into that discussion, so. Let the referees do their job.
They got the ball back anyway, so it's all right.
Yeah.
Let's see if Young can get it going real quick. Good
swings
pass to the corner.
And no, was able to miss that one. So it's going to be Bethune ball. That wasn't a bad possession for Alabama State, though.
Open three.
Yeah.
You live with it. If you miss it, you hope to make it, though.
Yeah. This is what they have to do. They have to continue the defensive pressure on Bethune, though.
Yep. Especially on ball pressure.
Right.
Because, look, now he gets a wide-open shot off the screen. And that's a good shot if you're Bethune.
Yeah.
Young with the laser.
Yeah, that was a great interior pass to the cutting big man, number 30.
Number 20, I believe. Kenny Strawbridge.
Mr. Strawbridge will go to the line. And the way that you do that, again, if we're looking at it here at replay, see, he's right there in the middle. The defenders had no choice but to grab his arm.
Yep.
Because they were going to give up an easy two-point bucket. And that's what you want your guards to do when they have the ball coming out of a rebound, looking down court, seeing who's down there. Strawbridge was ahead of the defense, which absolutely put him in the best position, and nobody was looking at him. And, you know, Mr. Young caught him and put it right on the money. He was not able to convert the first one. But we're going to see if he's able to get this in, cut the deficit to three.
They're still at that four-point barrier, it seems like.
And he gets it. That was the first game, though, wasn't it?
The first game was the 6 points. This one's been four. Well, let's see. Clark with the full-court pressure on Mr. Garrett. Looks like,
oh man, somebody missed an assignment just there.
Wide open, easy layup.
Yeah. Great entry pass there.
Looks like that's Mitchell that's checked into the game in the corner. See if he's ready to shoot.
Going strong to the basket.
O'Neal almost had the offensive board, wasn't able to get it. And Garrett kind of just falls to the ground and loses it, but he's able to retain possession, so they're going to get another crack at it.
Yeah, bodies on bodies, you know. Kind of surprised that was actually a lot of contact to not see a call.
Yeah, no whistle on that one.
Mr.
France is always ready to shoot. Look,
right, exactly. Mr. French was like, yeah, we're going to take this one. All right, maybe not. Nice move.
Garrett with a nice spin on the inside to get the easy lay.
Pushing the lead back up to 7 for Bethune-Cookman.
There's Mitchell with the step back, and he drains it right in French's face. A little right back at you.
Yeah. See what kind of defensive pressure the Hornets can get. Ooh, nice teardrop just over the outstretched hands of the defender.
Looks like Mitchell's trying to get something else going for himself. Clark with the ball. Time running low, so they got to kind of get a shot up quickly. O'Neal with the ball down low in the post. Wide open three. Not able to sink it in.
And like I said, one of the biggest things that's hurting Alabama State is no offensive or very few offensive rebounds.
Yep. They're only getting one shot at scoring the ball, where Bethune gets two or three every other possession. Mitchell with the rebound, screaming out the court with the good move on the inside.
And one
there
finish.
There you go. He's been a nice spark off the bench.
Yeah, yeah. Shout out to our boy, Mr. A.D. Drew, who would normally say, and he gets the hoop and the harm. So it looks like we have another timeout we're going to take right here. You're watching the Bridge Builder Classic on the Black College Sports Network, brought to you by HBCU League Pass.
Maureen is saving big holiday shopping at Amazon, so now she's free to become Maureen the Merrier. Food is her love language, and she really loves her grandson, like really loves.
Troy, you work here?
I'm never not working. Like Head & Shoulder Scalp Shield technology, up to 100% dandruff protection, even between washes.
Never not working.
Never not working. Never ever not working. Head & Shoulder Scalp Shield, never not working.
Welcome back to the Mitchell Center. Bethune-Cookman leads by a score of 52-47 over the Hornets of Alabama State. 11:40 left in the second half. Alabama State trying to cut this lead, get this game into a place where they can be ready to either take over or at least keep it close.
See if Mr. Mitchell can convert this and-one opportunity. See if he can have 6 quick points off the bench, and he does. And let's see what the offensive mindset for Bethune is going forward. They had success with French. He's kind of stalled out a little bit. Alabama came out with a better game plan on him at the second half. But let's see if they can get points from elsewhere. And Garrett staying aggressive, attacking the basket, and still drawing the foul, as he's always a regular at the free throw line. See if he can convert these 2 free throws and extend the lead a little bit.
Well, he's definitely making it difficult for the Hornets because he's putting pressure on them by driving into the lane.
Yep.
You know, and that's, again, that's one of the things that you want your guards to do.
And that's something that coaches preach, attack the basket, because that's how you get the defense to collapse, and that's how you get your shooters open. Wide open three-point shot when you when the defense collapses.
Yep. Converts the second, or score 48-53. As we were saying, let's see what we can get here the next 5 minutes of the game. See if we can keep some fluid play going.
Stewart from the corner.
And he bangs it down.
As he hits the Carmelo Anthony signature, the 3 point to the dome.
Yep, and now we have a 3 point game. Let's see if they can get a defensive stop here.
As they look like they switched to a 2-3 zone, back to the first few minutes strategy that they had at the beginning of this game. French all the way to the basket.
And are they giving him that?
Nope, they're not. They're going to be stingy. It appeared like he was on the ground, though. The bump came first, and then he went up. And that's Isaiah Range's third personal. He's going to have to watch it. Still got 10 minutes left in the game.
Yep.
As Bethune's able to get the ball up, French pulls up from three, and that man is money.
He has, as we like to say, ice water in his veins. And he refuses to let these Hornets get closer than 3 points.
And that's Christian McCray attempting the mid-range jumper. Doesn't get it to go in. He finds Mr. French. He's hitting the step back.
Got the defender up in the air. Get the foul. Go to the line for two.
His package of moves is ridiculous. They thought he was going to shoot a three, so he dribbled past them. The next defender came. He hit him with a step back. Knew he was going to jump. He pump fake, get him in the air, went up, and now he's at the free throw line.
That's it. Shout out to Mr. Rick Polk, who will be joining us at some of the games coming up here soon. As he would call it, the free 99.
Trace Young back in the game. See if they're able to get a little bit of offense from him. He's had a kind of a quiet night, quieter than usual.
Our lead is back up to 8 for the Wildcats. And like you said, we're going to see if Mr. Young will get aggressive and if he can make some things happen on the offensive end. Nice, strong move.
Isaiah Range.
That's what you want. Right now, I think that's what Alabama State needs. They need to aggressively go to the basket.
I'm not seeing a whole lot of that.
Yeah.
They're kind of waiting for something to happen, and they're not getting right into their offensive set, not being aggressive. Unlike Bethune, they're scoring with 5 seconds into the shot clock.
Yeah, and they are going to the rim. They are not just settling for shots. They're getting open shots because of the fact that they're attacking the paint.
Mitchell with the Euro, but he's blocked at the rim.
Oh, stolen.
Oh, Stewart gets the steal. Isaiah takes it to the cup.
Goes hard again. This is what they need to do. That is going to help them, especially in the transition like we talked about in the first half. If Alabama State can just get the ball moving quicker towards the rim, they are able to use their small ball to get beyond or get by some of these Bethune-Cookman defenders.
Fast break points are so hard to come by because they're so easy. The more you can get of them, the better you're going to win. The better your chances are going to be at winning the ball game. As Mitchell showing some aggression on the defensive side. Gets a jump ball, but Bethune sticks with it for right now.
61-55. 8 minutes, 40 seconds left in the contest.
As French is coming off the screen.
Looks like they may need to get that floor mopped out there. I've seen a couple of players look like they're kind of slipping over there right around the top of the key on that end. It's going to be a shot clock violation on the Wildcats. Ball will return over to the Hornets.
Isaiah Range in the backcourt bringing up the ball, running the offense. Drives all the way to the lane again. Doesn't get it to go this time. Bethune has numbers if they want them. Nope, just dribbles it out. Garrett being smart with the basketball. Takes time off the clock. Pulls up from the midi and he drills it right in Mitchell's face.
9-point lead again for the Wildcats.
Looks like Bama State is using that Trace Young and Isaiah Range pick and roll. See if it works. Air ball from the corner.
And we're going to get a timeout. 7 minutes, 31 seconds left in the contest. Bethune-Cookman leads by the score of 63-55. We'll be right back with more basketball right here on HBCU League Pass.
To aficionado, find yourself here. High-quality cigars plus personal customer service. Slow Burn is Waco's only mobile cigar lounge, featuring a meticulous, curated collection of premium cigars. Visit our website, www.slowburnwaco.com. That's www.slowburnwaco.com.
It's never too early to plant the seed, to share the tradition, and instill a sense of pride in your HBCU with your little ones. HBCU Pride and Joy Children's Boutique helps you share your school spirit with a wide selection of adorable kids' apparel and accessories officially licensed from your favorite HBCU. Visit HBCUPrideJoy.com and follow us on all social media at HBCU Pride Joy on Facebook and Twitter.
That spin class was brutal.
Well, you can try using the Buick's massaging seat.
Ooh, yeah, that's nice.
Can I use Apple CarPlay to put some music on?
Sure, it's wireless.
Pick something we all like.
Okay, hold on.
What's your Buick's Wi-Fi password?
Buick Envision 2021.
Oh, you should pick something stronger. That's really predictable.
That's a really tight spot.
Don't worry,
I used to hate parallel parking.
Me too.
Hey.
Really outdid yourself.
Yes, we did.
The all-new Buick Envision, an SUV built around you, all of you.
Welcome back. As Marty is doing a dance throughout history for the folks. Not really sure who Marty's dance teacher was. But yeah.
Let's see if he can Dougie.
And yes, so we are going back to the game at this point.
Sorry, Marty, you got to go, bud.
Yeah. 63-55, 7 minutes, 31 seconds left in the contest. Bethune-Cookman leads the Hornets of Alabama State. And at this point, this is when ASU is going to need to make their move. You know, this is going to be a very critical next 3 minutes of the game for them, I think. And I'm sure that Coach Thea has told his team that, and they are going to focus in, probably running a little bit more time down on the clock on their offensive things, looking for the best shots that they can get. Oh!
ASU starting off strong with a turnover right there.
Yeah.
That was all Stewart right there with the aggressive defense on French.
Yeah.
Let's see if they can get something together on offense, though. That's been their fall point right now. Clark in the corner, using that screen by Young. Oh, wide open in the corner. They need it.
Oh,
off the side of the backboard.
But that was a well-executed play. Drew two defenders. They were able to kick it out to the corner. Just shot was just off.
See if they can come back on defense. Get a few stops. That's Jacoby Long right there. With the sweet mid-range stroke.
Yeah. But again, look at where Bethune is taking their shots. All of their shots are in the paint.
Nice drive right there from E.J. Clark. But, yeah, I get what you're saying. They're all near the rim.
Yeah.
Because they're driving. They're being aggressive, and they're getting penetration. And right there, that's a clutch steal. See if Young can finish it.
Oh, great hands. Great hands there.
That's McIntyre right there getting back on defense with a huge stop because that was going to be easy two for ASU.
It definitely was.
That's Kenny Strawbridge right there. Kicks it out to Young. He needs it.
And he hits it. That is a big-time three right now.
That was big. That was big for their offense and his confidence.
Most definitely. I'm going to see how he looks the next time he comes back down. See if they look to get the ball in his hands again.
See if Clark and Stewart can force some ball pressure. French wide open three. And he misses.
Young with the rebound.
That's a rare sight. Case it to Strawbridge from three. In and out. Clark with the rebound.
And there you go. Offensive rebounds right at the right time for ASU.
But can they convert it? Can they make the most out of it? Strawbridge from the top of the key. Jab. Half spin. Lay. And he
gets and the one. One. And that's what you want. Right now, go to the basket.
And right now, you can feel the momentum kind of shifting. It was kind of in Bethune's favor. Now it's kind of switching over to Alabama State. Let's see if they can keep it up and convert this and one because they need all the points they can get.
Most definitely. Let's see if their crowd that's here made the trip down I-65. Is going to, after he shoots these three throws, are they going to try to get hyped up, get them a little bit more into the game? Fire the team up on the court.
Get the band going a little bit. And he finishes.
He converts it. And this is the closest that ASU has been in a very long time in this game. He's now down to 2 points.
And all the way to the cup.
Oh! Mr. Young with the block.
They have numbers.
Stewart from deep.
Boom!
Oh, he's in! We've got a game, folks. ASU takes the lead for the first time this half of the game. Timeout. Coach Theus. It's going to be a 30-second timeout. We're going to stay right here. This is what you wanted from ASU. This is what they wanted to see. Getting better shots. Getting aggressive on the defensive end. Turning into the fast point, the fast break points.
Yep. Like I said, it's all about hitting those open shots. Trace Young got it started going with a three from top of the key. Then he gets the huge swat. Stewart, who was kind of just feeling it, pulls it from deep, and it goes in.
That's right. And one of the things with that, what we're noticing, and this is one of the reasons that I said they need to try to do this more, their shooters are not spot-up shooters. They're catch and shoot. So you need to do this in your fast break offense. You need to get the ball. Get there. They had it. It was the perfect setup. You had three on the wing and two trailing. And the one that was there, he saw his man. He's going toward the basket. Continued to draw the defense as he ran forward. Kicked it back out to the three and bang. ASU takes the lead.
And now we have a whole new game.
And that's going to be a blocking. No, they're going to.
Wow.
Okay. Again. I'm not paid to be in stripes.
I might have just let that one go. That's a tough one to call, especially with a guy setting a screen right there. Let's see if French can get back on track. Ball in his hands and looking for him to be a scorer. Kicks it to the big man. There's Long right there. McIntyre takes it in, kicks it to French. He's dribbling it in, fade away. And it's off the mark. But an offensive rebound.
Nope,
Stewart takes it. But there's a foul on McIntyre. And Alabama State's going to get the ball going the other way with the lead.
Actually, it looks like they are. Okay, yeah, they're just going to give him the ball. They're not going to get the shots on that one.
Yeah, they're not in the bonus yet. That was the 15th foul, I believe.
Yep. Let's see what they are able to do. 66-65. 4:19 left in the contest. Alabama State with their first lead in a very long time in this game.
Going up top. Bam!
Mr. Young!
Trace Young, he's flashing the jersey. He's getting up in the sky for the slam.
ASU is feeling it right now. Let's see if their defense matches it. They're going to have to not give up these fouls, though.
Yep. Jordan O'Neal didn't really need that foul right there. You got all the momentum. You got all the swagger on your side. You just didn't need that whistle right there.
Yeah. It's going to be an official timeout. We're going to take us a break. Our score, Alabama State 68, Bethune-Cookman 65. This is the Bridge Builders Classic, live from Mobile, Alabama, on the Black College Sports Network on HD. All right, TJ, we are back here at the Mitchell Center on the campus. South Alabama University, after trailing by more than four most of this game, the ASU Hornets have come back to take the lead by three. 68-65, 3 minutes, 57 seconds left. Your coach, Theus, what did you tell your team?
I tell them this is stay calm and let the nerves kind of ring out a little bit. Yeah, they got the momentum going, but let's get into our offensive sets. Let's swing the ball. Let's continue to drive in. Let's do how we've been doing the whole game to get to where we are right now.
And what did Coach Williams tell his team?
Oh, keep it up. They got all the momentum right now, right? And they're just trying to finish out the ball game. So I think we're going to be set up for a thriller to finish off this classic.
Most definitely. This is going to be a great game to finish out this nightcap of this doubleheader of HBCU football today. He converts both, cutting the lead to 1 point.
McIntyre picking up full court. Clark able to shake him off a little bit. Young with the ball at the free throw line. Draped by Bethune-Cookman. Oh, and he comes up a little bit short on that one-hander.
What I did not like about that play, TJ, there were no white jerseys in the paint for rebounds.
None.
He was the only ASU player in the paint. They cannot have that happen in these last 3 minutes of the game. Someone is going to have to be in the paint with whoever the shooter is. There's got to be another body in there because Bethune is crashing the boards.
Let's see if they're able to do that on this offensive possession. Clark kicks it to Stewart on the wing. He finds Kenny at the top.
There's going to be called. They're going to call a foul on that one.
Over the back, I believe. Are they in the bonus?
They are. No. ASU is not in the bonus yet. Bethune-Cookman is in the bonus.
Let's see what Coach Williams has drawn up. Stewart from the corner.
Teammates on the bench looking for him to take the three.
He takes it in. Clark in the corner. Finds Young. Down low.
Oh, that's going to be a foul. Definitely going to send him to the line for that one.
Nice hands by O'Neal right there, ready for the strong pass inside. Now he's got two free throws to extend their lead. See if he can do it.
2 minutes, 55 seconds left in the contest. Converts the first.
Free throws.
They can be the bane of your existence or they can be your savior. He converts both. ASU picking up full court pressure.
That's kind of a lazy pass. I don't like that if I'm Bethune's coach.
Yeah, right now you've got to pay attention to what's going on, what the defense is doing. So you've got to be very careful on how you're throwing these balls around.
Yep. Looks like they're just going straight man-to-man the last 3 minutes. Garrett smothered by Stewart. French at the top of the key. He drives in, open mid-range, and he's off. He's got a little bit cold right here, Roy.
He sure has. Mr. Young with another rebound.
Finds E.J. Clark to set up the offense.
70-67, ASU with the lead. 2 minutes, 20 seconds left in the contest.
Finds Young from the wing.
He looks it up. And he hits another one. Coach Williams says, no more profiling, young man. Get back on defense. But the young man's confidence is very high right now, giving them their largest lead, 73-67.
Bethune responds with a three. Doesn't get it to go, but they're going to stay with the ball.
Yep.
Who was that, number 12 from Bethune? That was Kevin Davis from three.
Mr. Mitchell checking back into the game for the Hornets in his last 2 minutes.
Bethune down by six. Where do they go for offense? French gone a little bit cold. Garrett takes it to the rim.
Oh, that's what you do. You go right back to what has been giving you the best results the entire game. Going to the rim, you're either going to get a great shot or you're going to get the foul and you're going to go to the line. Both teams now in the bonus. They'll be shooting for the rest of the game.
And he misses it. That's tough. Now, it's still a two-possession game, but that would have extremely helped your cause.
Yeah.
Got to knock this one down. They've been stuck at 67 for quite a while.
They have. And he sinks that second one. And Bethune actually picks up some full court pressure as well. Going back to the man-to-man again, as we see, of course.
Returning the favor a little bit. Young with the ball. He's been hot the last 5 minutes.
And he's going to be aggressive.
And he's at the line.
They call that a one-and-one.
Yep.
Shooting
converts the first.
And he really found himself coming out of halftime.
He did. He did.
Little shaky first half, you know, lost his confidence a little bit. But as soon as he hit that three from the top, that's when he really started to lock in. Then he hit another one. Then he had that big dunk. Then another three. And now these clutch free throws.
But this is exactly what I was saying. You have to get aggressive. You know, your offensive leaders and scorers have to be aggressive at going to the basket and going after their offense. Not waiting. Sometimes you can't just wait for it to come to you.
Yep. Got to go get it sometimes. Kevin Davis takes it to the rack. Up and under, doesn't get it to go.
Doesn't fall.
Young with a big rebound. As he finds E.J. Clark at the top of the key as he dribbles out Coach and tries to get some ticks off the clock.
Yeah, Coach Mo wants them to use some of this time on the clock. 75-68 ASU, 1 minute left in the game. 13 seconds on the shot clock.
Young with the screen. He's going to have to put it up, and I think he will. From deep.
That's going to be an air ball. But right there, again, though, those few seconds really help them out. Again, getting your hand on the ball for these offensive rebounds, these offensive touches, and getting it in. You're putting the pressure.
Bethune's got to get a shot up. They don't
really
have much
do.
Time.
Yeah. That's going to be a jump ball. Are we seeing possession arrows? Foul. Wow.
Foul. Bethune took way too much time off the clock there. You're down by five. No, you're down by seven.
Seven.
Yeah. Down by seven. You got to get up and go. And your shot has to be a three. Can't go to the rim. Now you got to play the foul game.
32.4 seconds left. Converts the first. He's helping their cause.
Kevin Davis brings him to within six. Still going to be a two-possession game whether he makes or miss.
The key is, though, if he misses, ASU has to corral this rebound. He doesn't. Coach Reggie Theus calls a timeout.
I'm surprised there wasn't an intentional miss there to potentially get offensive rebound and get another shot up. But
well, we're on a full timeout, so we're going to take us a break. You're watching HBCU football right here on the Black College Sports Network, brought to you by HBCU League Pass.
Too early to plant the seed, to share the tradition, and instill a sense of pride in your HBCU with your little ones. HBCU Pride and Joy Children's Boutique helps you share your school spirit with a wide selection of adorable kids' apparel and accessories officially licensed from your favorite HBCU. Visit HBCUPrideJoy.com and follow us on all social media at HBCU Pride Joy on Facebook and Twitter.
This is the Dean of the College of HBCU Sports, Kenyatta Cavill of Dr. Cavill's Inside the HBCU Sports Lab with Mike Washington and Charles Bishop. Come mix it up in the lab where the course lecture is in session every Tuesday from 6 o'clock p.m. Central Standard Time on Facebook Live, YouTube, Spreaker, or the BCSN app. As we discuss all things about the HBCU sports culture, including exploring the week that was in the sporting HBCU dashboard, as well as the upcoming week of HBCU Sports. With me, the Dean, the College of HBCU Sports, on Dr. Cavill's Inside HBCU Sports Lab with Mike Washington and Charles Bishop. Course lecture dismissed.
And we are back. 32.4 seconds left on the clock. ASU with a 5-point lead after literally trailing the entire game.
That's exactly what you don't want if you're Coach Williams. Bad passes coming out of a timeout. But they're still able to get the ball. Now they're going to the free throw line. And it's a matter of making your free throws or not.
They can wrap this one up from the foul line.
Or they can make it interesting.
This is true.
Sinks the first. And if he makes this one, it's not looking too good for Bethune.
Makes it a three-possession game. And he does.
No need to foul if you're Alabama State.
None whatsoever. Just stay in front of your man. Ooh, with a clutch three. But there it is. That ball's going to stay to ASU.
What are you doing? If you're dribble the ball out, you'll need to go for a layup.
And the coach probably was talking. I mean, the young man probably was thinking that, hey, we get more points on the board. It keeps us up. You know, it continues to make it a three possession game. As a player, I can understand that as a player. That was his first thought. But it looks like that's what the coach is letting him know. It's like, yep. Hey, we're up. Pull that back out. Set the offense. Let your teammates get down there to help you out.
And these are all teaching moments. Yeah,
exactly. And these are good teaching moments because these are the types of situations that you expect to be in, yep, once we get to conference play or tournament play.
And it's tough to emulate these same, you know, situations
in practice. Yeah. The intensity isn't there. The pressure isn't there, and that's the biggest thing.
Yep, and the stakes are not the same at all.
Exactly. In practice, you know that there's nothing on the line. Situations like this, it makes it much better for them to get to that point where they're like, okay, you know, let me think through the process and not just react. So, again, we are here at the inaugural Bridge Builder Classic, our second contest of the night. ASU is 16.8 seconds away from getting out of here with the lead, or with the victory, rather.
A little bit of
and,
a delay,
oh, that's right.
Maybe.
They're reviewing it because they want to see what exactly they want to get it right. See what they're going to call here.
Yep, I'm looking to see if it's a flagrant or.
I don't know. I don't know if they're looking at it to see if it's a flagrant. I think they were probably just looking at it more to see if it was a foul or if the ball went out of bounds off of one of the other players.
Oh, okay. Oh, I don't think they called a foul.
They didn't, and I think that's why they were looking at to see initially. They can, if I'm not mistaken, they can come back and call the foul if they see one.
Yep.
But the key was they were looking to see who the ball went off of, and that's what the issue was.
Now
it went off of the ASU player.
Now it's Bethune's ball, and if they score, get a quick bucket, preferably a three, they have action.
We'll see. But they're gonna put pressure on everybody except the inbounder.
Get the ball up quick.
And throw it away. Mr. Young got it. Great way to step into the passing lane.
And that's a crusher right there.
Yeah. That is a clutch play by a player who's come to play in the second half. Totally stepped up his game on both ends of the court. And was able to step into the passing lane.
And that kind of sums up Bethune's second half.
Yeah.
Turnovers, sloppy play, and they lost the lead because of that.
Oh, he misses. But he's
double
shooting.
Bonus.
He's shooting two, right? So yeah,
double
he's
bonus,
still
I
shooting.
Believe, yeah. But still, you're leaving the door open. Even if you make this one.
Yeah. It's still only a two-pointer, two possession game. One shot. Let's see what he's able to do. And he converts.
Now, are they able to get a shot off? He's taking it all the way to the rim. And that's going to wrap
it
up.
There it is. ASU with the rebound. But you're absolutely right. That is going to do it. 2 seconds left on the clock. Mr. Jordan O'Neal shooting two for the Hornets. Gets both of them. For ASU with 2 seconds left. You're going to get that, but that's going to be the end of the contest. And we're going to be wrapping it up. We're going to go ahead and wrap it up here. It has been a great day. It's been a great day here in Mobile, Alabama. Getting the victory in the first game. The Tigers of Grambling State University. Getting the victory in the second game of the inaugural Bridge Builders Classic. The ASU Hornets right up the street fought back from being down most of the entire game. Great comeback. This is a great win for Coach Williams and his team. And I know they're going to be happy headed back home. They get to 50. They get 500 to 500
in the conference play.
In the conference play, and it'll be moving forward. So on behalf of Kim Wright, TJ Wills, the Bridge Builder Classic, I am Roy Evans. Thank you for joining us here on the Black College Sports Network presented by HBCU League Pass. Stay tuned. Check us out, mybcsn.net. Follow us on all social media at mybcsn and the number one. We will have our spring schedule released on Monday. See all the games and things that we'll have coming up for the next couple of months. Men's and women's basketball, baseball, softball, and of course it is all HBCU centered, HBCU related. Until next time, you all have a great evening, and we will see you.